Hand Down the Law. It is happening early and often here with Rod Chico Tanner and my man, James Pleasure. Something new happened in the world of sports, something huge. And ESPN rolled out the SEC Network. And another bad brother is definitely with us on the line. Has a 210 area code, so I believe he knows about the San Antonio area. So we welcome to the show back Peter Burns, the SEC Network studio host. My man, welcome back to Laying Down the Law.
One lonely beastie I be.
Yes.
That was impressive, man. Rolling with a little Paul Revere on a Sunday morning. I like it, guys.
Doing the SEC Network in Charlotte, NC.
Man, look at that. That's pretty good.
Hey, I do a little. They won't let me sing. Freestyle, I am unlimited, but yeah, they will not.
He can have all the freestyle he wants.
But will not let
me
sing.
When it comes to the R&B vocals.
I am back.
Auto-tune it. Just auto-tune it.
Hey, we have a band.
I might be able to touch a tambourine or a cymbal.
Yes,
percussion. Peter Burns, man, congratulations. I wanted to let you know that on air publicly. And wow, for a guy that has appreciation for the SEC, LSU in particular, your thoughts, man, about the ESPN SEC Network?
No, man, it's gonna be fun. Obviously, it's a once in a lifetime opportunity, but it's kind of one of those things where, I mean, listen, I'm in Baton Rouge right now, and I don't think my parents have turned it off the SEC Network since they launched on Thursday at 6 p.m. And what I realized down here, in these SEC cities, that's just going to be the new way. That's going to be what people want to tune in. I mean, being in Big 12 country as I was then, my gosh, for over 20 years there in San Antonio and kind of Austin area, you understand that, hey, listen, college football is big. But when you come down and you go into Tuscaloosa, when you're there in when you're there in Baton Rouge, any of these other SEC cities, it's just a way of life because they don't have a Spurs organization. They don't have professional sports. Their college team is their professional sport. So they are so tuned into everything and anything SEC related that I think we had a shot at a couple of people watching us.
Absolutely. And Peter, I loved how it pained you to say, like, Oxford or Athens or something.
Oh,
like that.
Yeah. I mean, any of that, Columbia, it's gotten to the point where, Knoxville is just, it rolls off the tongue a little slower. But you know what? That's the cool part about it. I mean, obviously, it's not just one school. It's 14 different universities. And, a lot of people have said, well, it's only be about Bama. It's only going to be about football. And that's really not the case. I mean, it's going to be all of the different universities, and more importantly, even all of the different sports. I mean, SEC sports is known for college football, obviously, but, we just had Vanderbilt that just won the College World Series. You had Bama that won men's golf. You've got Kentucky that does pretty decent in SEC basketball. So it's going to be all the sports that are going to be pretty big.
No, you're absolutely right. We're speaking with Peter Burns, the new SEC Network studio host. James.
Hey, Peter, what's going on?
What's up, man? I just it just feels weird even when you say it again.
We're going to keep saying it so it becomes very familiar for you.
There you go.
So, some big news out of A&M this weekend is it appears they've found the heir apparent to Johnny Manziel down there to take the field on August 28th on the SEC Network against South Carolina down there in Columbia.
Yeah, I mean, when you look at Kenny Hill, it was the idea that coming in that someone needed to have somebody that had taken a couple snaps. They really like Kyle Allen. Even Kyle Allen yesterday tweeted out, "Don't count me out of this yet." And I think that's just the safe play for Sumlin. Allen's more of, obviously, as you guys know, a little bit more of a drop back passer. He's more of a pocket guy. He's got all the skills in the world to be a stud. But the kid also looks like he's 14. I mean, he's stature wise, he's huge. He's just so baby faced, and he hasn't seen that live action when the lights come on. And to go on the road to open up the season I mean, it's even weirder whenever you're one of the first games across NCAA football, not just the first Saturday, because even more eyes are going to be on you. So at least Kenny Hill has done it before, and he can move around the pocket. So I like the choice by Sumlin. I don't have any issues with it, but I got to be honest with you, I think both of them play a little bit of time this year.
Peter, I have a solution for coaches from Pop Warner through the SEC right in the NFL Network.
Uh-oh.
When you get concerned about play calling, you can turn around and hand it to a guy like me. I am more than happy to follow guys with the numbers of 60s and 70s and 50 anywhere we need to go just to calm you down so you can have an extra 45 seconds to call another play. Hand the ball off.
Well, guess what? That's going to happen a lot in the SEC. The SEC that people grew to love yet last year with Manziel and Murray and Mettenberger and all those guys putting up just absolute monster numbers, that ain't going to happen. You're going to go back to – you're going to revert to like 2011, 2009 SEC this year because this is probably as wide open as the conference has been because you've got all these new quarterbacks. I mean, you've got probably three teams right now. I know Vanderbilt, Kentucky – LSU, and even Bama. That's four programs right now that still don't know and that still haven't that decided to start it yet. So, I mean, there's going to be a lot of uncertainty with the quarterback position in the SEC, and you're right. It's just going to be, hey, take us a couple steps back, hand it to guys like Todd Gurley and hand it to Mike Davis and all these unbelievable Derrick Henry. I mean, Alabama's running back trio – could start in the NFL right now. I'm not joking about that. T.J. Yeldon's going to be a stud. Derrick Henry, 6'4", 245 pounds, and I think runs like a 2.840. I mean, he's illegal to give him the ball.
Right.
And then they got Kenyon Drake. I mean, that is as good as a trio as you saw a couple years ago where you had Darren McFadden, you had Felix Jones, and Peyton Hillis. Those three guys all played for the 07 Arkansas team. I mean,
Yes. That's
pretty potent type running back. And so you're going to see a lot of more of a defensive, rushing, hard-nosed football, kind of a return back to its roots of SEC football.
A guy that we're all kind of familiar with down here in this area is Will Muschamp, the former defensive coordinator at the University of Texas. How hot is his seat getting over there in Florida right now with the season they had the last few years?
No, I mean, it's make or break for him. I mean, he's got to win eight games, I think. Or he's got to at least be Georgia. I mean, that's, you know, it's so funny when you go into some of these SEC schools, what happens is that there's an and or part of success for your season. It's how many wins did you have, or did you beat your rival? And if you don't have a good season and you lose to your rival again, all bets are off. You're done. You might as well be looking for a new job. And that's upsetting for Muschamp because I think Muschamp can coach. I just think that he had some issues of getting on the right page and getting that whole program ready to roll. But the big difference is now he's got Jeff Driscoll. He's going to be healthy because, remember, he broke his leg or had a leg injury early in the season, I think game three. And now he's got Kurt Roper, the offensive coordinator out of Duke. And, I mean, listen, if you can make Duke look good, you darn sure can go ahead and make Florida athletes look pretty good. So I think he's going to be fine. I don't think that they win 11 games or 10 games, but I like them winning about 9 games in the SEC. And I think that'll be enough to keep Muschamp one more year.
We're talking with Peter Burns, SEC Network studio host. You can get it on ESPN. So many people were happy, especially on DirecTV, that your face showed up, Peter. So I know it's going to be. Tell us, you know, in your ventures, and they haven't been long, what's some of the coolest things that you've had the opportunity to do, and what are they going to let you do that, you know, guys like us really go, wow. My man's doing, you know, he's moving up like George Jefferson.
Man, you know, I mean, just a couple of days ago, being able to tour all of LSU's facilities and sit down with Les Miles, who's, you know, obviously, you know, for me, I had to make sure I didn't do, you know, Chris Farley on Saturday Night Live.
That's yeah.
Remember that time we went for him on fourth down? That was awesome. You know, and I got a chance to go down to Columbia and get a little all access with South Carolina and sat down with Steve Spurrier and Dylan Thompson, their quarterback. And it's really kind of a little bit behind the scenes of being able to see it. And then I got to be honest with you, it's just more of the stuff off air. Like, you know, a couple days ago, we had all of our crew there in Charlotte for the opener. So it's Tebow, it's Paul Feinbaum, it's Joe Tessitore, it's Marcus Spears and Booger McFarland and Greg McElroy. All of these names, you know, we're sitting in a little green room having lunch, and we're just talking football. I mean, no one was anybody special. It was just talking about football with a bunch of guys that knew what they were talking about. So, and I think that's the more laid back approach we're going to have. We're not going to try to be, too earth shattering with anything. We're going to have fun. We're going to talk about the SEC, and I think we'll be all right.
One more before we get you off here, Peter. You look at that opening game on August 28th, A&M, South Carolina. You mentioned it. South Carolina's got a new quarterback coming in. A&M's got a new quarterback taking the reins. You got no Jadeveon Clowney. What are we looking for out of this game, and what's your early prediction on who wins?
You're going to see – I think South Carolina wins, no doubt. I mean, I don't think A&M's defense has gotten that much better than it was last year. But the problem is they don't have an offense like Manziel to go ahead and cover up for it. I really like Dylan Thompson, the quarterback. Very cool kid. When I met him down in Columbia, he was just very – just real laid back and calm, and I really like that. He's a fifth year senior, if I'm not mistaken, fifth year or fourth year senior. So the thing is, they got a running back down there, Mike Davis, who's incredible. Yeah, a very good kid. But Spurrier likes to throw the ball, so I think the thing you want to look for in that first game is Spurrier going to trust himself enough to run the ball, because Spurrier always likes to pass it. So, and people down there in Columbia shake their head because they think, hey, this running back is as good as Todd Gurley or any of these other guys. So let's see if Spurrier runs the ball, you know, gives the ball to Mike Davis over 25 times. If he gets it over 25 times, South Carolina's winning that game going away.
Peter Burns, we certainly appreciate you. We look forward to all your work on ESPN's SEC Network. As the studio host and all the interviews and the great things, please, if you can carve out a little time for us here and there to let us know and the listeners know what's going on there to the southeast of the country, that'd be great, man. And certainly congratulations again on your opportunity and best of luck.
Hey, I appreciate it. For you, anytime. So just you guys hit me up, and hopefully we'll have some good stories to talk about this season.
Sounds great, man. Be safe. Enjoy Baton Rouge, and travel safe. It's going to be coming up sooner than we know. We'll be tweeting about it. Oh, yeah, how can people follow you and find you? You'll be doing great things photo-wise and information-wise.
Yeah, I mean, just on Instagram and on Twitter, it's Peter Burns ESPN. So that's pretty easy to go ahead and follow, and hopefully I won't get suspended for stuff that I tweet anytime soon.
I tell you what, Pete, just for you and me, we'll give you the free laying down the law attorney discount. Just hit me up on a direct message, and I'll do what I can. Even if I'm not licensed in the state, I know a few folks around the country.
There it is, man. I'm going to take you up on that offer.
Will they really suspend you for koala pictures?
No, not the koala pictures. In fact, I think they're actually going to let me roll that into our SEC Now highlight show occasionally. So, I just got to find the right chance to use it.
Absolutely. Peter Burns, thanks.